Rhizoctonia, tell us, as you were walking through a paddock, what would you be looking out for then?
Primarily, you're looking for the distinct patches, as we can see in the field in here. But it depends when the infection occurs. So if you get early infection, you do get the distinct patches. That is, it's affecting the seminal roots. Whereas if you get later infection, the crown roots, you often get the waviness. And we've got some waviness here too. So it might be potentially both have occurred here. Infection can occur all the way through the growing season. It's not in a particular time. And that's what makes it very difficult to control.
And a serious impact, no doubt, on the production in the paddock.
Yeah, it's estimated to cost the grower wheat and barley annually $27 million in Western Australia. So it's quite a big problem. It is widespread. We've seen it all the way from salmon gums up to the northern region. So it's a widespread issue.
And digging under the ground, no doubt, is a really important thing in the root condition like this.
It's really important to look below the ground at the roots. So above the ground, it could be nematodes, it could be Rhizoctonia. It's not often easy to distinguish between the two. And you can actually get both co-occurring together. So when you dig up the roots, then you get a distinct symptomology for Rhizoctonia. You get that spear tipping, and we can see it on these particular plants here. There's some distinct spear tipping on the crown roots, and that would be what is Rhizoctonia. With any root pathogen, it's really very difficult to do anything at that time. So you need to get the correct diagnosis so that you can understand what the issue is, and then you can do something about it in the next season. For Rhizoctonia, it's very tricky because there's so many susceptible hosts. So all the cereals are susceptible. Barley is the most susceptible of all. Canola, even the weeds are very susceptible too. So if you've got a lot of weeds in your paddock, especially over summer, you can keep that inoculum increasing over that time, which then when you put your crop in, you have a bigger problem potentially. So even weeds are potential hosts as well. Come the growing season, I mean, at the moment what we have are a number of seed treatments, and they do offer some protection. In our trials, on average, about 5%. It can be either way. We had, I think, up to 15% control. But we're also working on some new potential control options that hopefully will get released in the next year or two. And they'll offer up to 15, 20% control. As I said, in terms of rotation, it's very hard, although we did find for canola that the inoculum levels do seem to drop down a bit. But if you've got a paddock with really high inoculum, then it may not actually solve the problem for you. And as I said, canola is susceptible anyway.
And what are the key messages?
Key messages are make sure you have the diagnosis correct. Look at the roots and identify what the primary problem is, and also send away your samples to get that diagnosis correct.